I host my own website on Scalahosting. I also host all of my business tools here as well. And I recently made a review on Scalahosting. But in that video, I didn't have the time or the energy to detailize some of the lesser known, but very, very helpful features that make Scalahosting a standout host for me. So in this video, I wanna do just that. Starting off with actually unlimited resources, an absolute S-tier feature, and the main reason why Scalahosting feels so much faster, even with seemingly fewer resources allocated upon purchase. So all web hosting providers use physical hardware. That's just a fact. But physical hardware can be virtualized. For example, if you have a physical CPU with 4 cores, you can take those 4 physical cores and the resources they offer and turn them into 16 virtual cores, redistributing the power in 16 parts instead of 4 parts. Why would you do this? Well, so you could sell more plans. If you only have 4 cores and your plan gives users 1 core, this means that with 1 CPU, you can only sell 4 plans. But if you virtualize these resources, now you turn your 1 CPU investment into 16 potential sales. Most web hosting companies partake in this practice. The problem is, virtualizing CPU cores doesn't magically make the CPU more powerful. It still has the same finite amount of resources it's able to output. Except now, instead of sharing those resources in 4 parts, you're sharing between 16 users. Web hosting providers are essentially banking on the fact that users who buy these plans have no idea what they're doing, and they won't utilize the resources they have to 100%, meaning they can get away with it. And some companies even go as far as implementing hard CPU throttling, making sure your website straight up gets slowed down on purpose if you hit 20% of CPU usage, just so their virtualization scheme can go on. Imagine paying for a CPU core that technically you can only use 20% of. You kind of feel ripped off if this happens. Well, Scalahosting does not take part in this gamble. They have a strict policy of 1 physical CPU core equals 1 virtual CPU core. So you're never in a situation where your performance might randomly degrade because the provider you're using is overselling their servers. And on top of that, they do not have any automatic suspension tools in place that would limit your account on 20% or 30% usage. On the contrary, they allow you to use as much as 300% of your CPU power for a short period of time. You can do this 5 times in 10 days without even getting a warning. And that's exactly what you want from your server if you're serious. Stable, consistent power with some upward buffer zones if your posts or videos ever go viral and you need to handle the extra influx of users without getting in trouble. So if my website gets a surge of traffic due to a well-performing article, I know my business won't get penalized by the hosting provider, and I'm getting what I paid for, not just a part of it. On top of this, there are no inode limits at Scalahosting. For those who don't know, inodes are a secondary measurement unit for file storage. 1 file equals 1 inode. It doesn't matter if it's a 1 gigabyte file or a 1 kilobyte file, it still takes up 1 inode. So providers usually give out plenty of storage space, like 100 gigabytes, so it seems like you can host almost anything there. But there's a very sneaky inode limit of, let's say, 100,000 inodes. That means even if your files only take up 10 gigabytes of the 100, there can't be more than 100,000 files on your server. If you reach the inode limit, you cannot store any more files, no matter how much storage space is left on your server. This can feel very deceiving and quickly becomes problematic with email storage, because each individual message is 1 inode. Or caching plugins, because Lightspeed Cache, WP Rocket, or W3 Total Cache create individual files per page, with a large site generating as much as 50,000 or more files per website just for the cash? Well, Scalahosting does not impose an inode limit. You're free to use all of your available storage, no matter how many individual files it takes to fill up that storage. By the way, you can get 10% off absolutely any Scalahosting plan if you use the link in the description and click here. This will preload a coupon code that will work upon checkout. Based on the plan you're getting, this can save you a pretty good chunk of cash. And you might want to try out Scala because of another exclusive feature. Scalahosting guarantees your website will load in 2 seconds or less if you migrate to their managed VPS or you get all of your money back. All you need to do is fill out this form and one of their technicians will personally take a look at your site, optimize it, transfer it, and make sure it's as fast as it can be, loading in 2 seconds or less. Or you get all of your money back. This is just a no-risk solution if you feel your website is slow. What you're essentially getting is a professional website optimization services for free, as long as you have a plan, and if they determine that the overall problems cannot be solved with a faster hosting solution or website optimizations, basically just needs a whole code rewrite, you lose absolutely nothing. They will give you your money back. Since I manage more than just my website, I have client websites on Scalahosting as well. I highly value and recommend this feature alongside the Scalahosting migration services. Yes, they offer truly free migration to Scalahosting for an unlimited number of sites. And they get everything: content, design, emails, a full clean migration. They're one of the very few providers who will migrate non-WordPress websites or from different control panels, like a cPanel to sPanel migration or direct admin to cPanel. Website transfers are not easy. A website transfer tutorial is still one of the most popular videos on my channel. I know people struggle with it a lot, so having a provider do it free, with no downtime and properly, without leaving any bits or crumbs behind, is such an awesome feature that I use all the time when migrating client sites. And I know that a lot of web hosting providers actually advertise free migrations, but it's not always such cut and dry solutions. Here's a quick chart of how different web hosting providers handle migrations. Despite advertising it being free, most still require manual work for emails or only work with cPanel or WordPress-based websites, or just one website in general. So if you're migrating to Scalahosting, don't do it yourself. Let them handle it for you, because trust me, they know what they're doing. And finally, we have the anytime money-back guarantee. What this means is that if you use the link in the description and get a Scalahosting entry cloud plan with a 10% discount for 3 years, that will cost you $484 or $161 per year. Now, if you use the service for 1 year and decide your project is no longer needed, you still effectively have 2 years or $322 worth of hosting left in your account. That would be essentially wasted with other web hosting providers. But with Scalahosting, you can refund the amount that's remaining at any time. So in this case, if you ask for a refund 1 year later, you would get back $322 of your original $484 payment. This is not a gimmick. I've read through their terms of service, and I've even used this in the past. They're legit. The only catch is that once you renew a plan, that's not refundable anymore. So if you refund within the first 3 years, that's okay. But after the 3 years are up and you decide to renew your plan for 3 more years, that period is no longer covered, because you're no longer a new customer, you're a returning customer. And that kind of makes sense. Scalahosting is protecting themselves from fraud, because upon renewal, the prices are higher, and I can't see situations where people would just exploit this. Because if you're unsure about Scalahosting after the 3 years that you're using it, I mean, just don't renew the service. It's as simple as that. Of course, you can find more detailed information on how the interface looks and feels, performance tests, and all of that good stuff in this video right here. This is the full review I've mentioned in the beginning of the video. I just wanted to expand on some lesser known facts I couldn't fit in the main video. Hope you find this one useful, and I'll see you in the next one.